I want to put up the photo that's caused a lot of controversy over the last 12 hours. This was posted by the First Lady Melania Trump on Twitter, and she's holding a baby boy. I spoke incorrectly before, and I said it was a baby girl. This is a baby boy who lost his parents in the massacre in El Paso. And the reason this photo is causing controversy is because, look, the First Lady's smiling. The president's flashing the thumbs up there. And this baby lost his parents. Now, people look at this and say, Earl, how could you take a picture flashing a thumbs up with an orphan like that, essentially? The other side of it is that the uncle who was standing in that photo is a Trump supporter. Apparently, the father who was killed was also a Trump supporter. There is that context there still. You know, you take a step back when you see that.
Yeah, well, it is. I would fault, frankly, the president's staff, right? I mean, the president himself, you know, you put him in front of a camera, he's going to do what politicians do. You know, they smile, they flash, they give their little thumbs up, they do what they're going to do. They needed to stage that quite a bit differently if they knew it was going to be for public consumption. Frankly, if this individual, if he's a big Trump supporter, if he wanted to say, look, it would be the honor of my life, I'm meeting the president of the United States, even in the middle of this tragedy, you know, I'm proud to meet the president, that's one thing. But for public consumption, on what is a public trip, on which every step, every photo, every word is supposed to be, if not scripted, at least thought about. I'd say they really fell down.
Well, and the fact that it was tweeted out, too, by the First Lady, the photo, it would have been, to your point, Errol, a little bit different if this had come from the uncle who was there in the picture saying, what an honor to meet the president today. But seeing that tweeted out by the First Lady with the thumbs up sign, it's tough to ignore those optics.
I mean, there was a tone deafness to the visit as a whole. And I think, you know, we're seeing that from the president's aides even saying that this didn't go quite so well. President flies into El Paso. There are protests everywhere. There's a lack of empathy coming from the president. So I think this is just another example of that level of tone deafness.
That's the issue. I mean, apparently, reportedly, the baby was brought back to the hospital. They tried to keep the press out. And some of the footage that's come out of the president's talking about how big the crowd size of his rally in El Paso was. And then this photo. What you have is a picture of a president who has an empathy deficit. He keeps acting like a malfunctioning automaton with these opportunities. Here, he's with an orphan child, and he reflexively does the grin and the thumbs up. That's just an empathy gap. And it's not too much to expect the president would act like a normal human being. But instead, he's talking to the doctors at this hospital, which is flooded with shooting victims, and talking about how big his crowds were a few weeks ago. That's not a normal human response.
Or a helpful.
No.
A human response, which is the most important thing, I think, to the victims and the families of the victims and the people in El Paso and Dayton. Not helpful.